Welcome back. In this video, we're going to take a look at how we can track our enhanced e-commerce promo clicks with the help of Google Tag Manager and our custom JavaScript variable. So like in the last tutorial, we already had a closer look at how we can set up such a data layer inside of a custom JavaScript variable. Now we want to also track our actual clicks. Now these enhanced e-commerce tracking data layers are always built the same, but for our data layer here, we have a promo click as the action. And this is something we would need to change in our tracking deployment for promo clicks. So let's take a look at the specification here. Down below, we here have the measuring promotion clicks, and we want to do the same as with the other one. Now, I'm gonna just copy the whole thing here, the whole data layer push. In our case, this would be this here. I'm gonna copy this, and we're gonna go over to Google Tag Manager and build an enhanced e-commerce tracking promo view. I'm just gonna copy this, and gonna call this enhanced promo click. Now, we had our data layer before. I'm just going to replace this. So here we have our data layer. As I said, we are not really pushing anything into the data layer. We just need the e-commerce object. So we can get rid of anything right here, data layer push, and back here. Now, this is built especially for a tracking scenario where you would forward the user on and you want to ensure that the data is actually transferred. And this is done with an event callback. We can get rid of this portion as it is deployed through a variable here. So I'm going to get rid of these data points as well. And this should give us our enhanced e-commerce tracking object, except of the event up here. This one is also something we wouldn't need as we are not deploying a data layer. We want to simply have our e-commerce data object. Now you see this promo object ID, promo object name, and so on. This actually needs to refer to the same data that was actually viewed. So we need to have the same data in here as we had from the one that is viewed. So I'm going to just save this for now. Go over to our view here and copy out our promotions view here. All right, let's go over to the click data and tap that in as we had it before. So now we are clicking on the same data as we are viewing. And if you know about enhanced e-commerce tracking, you know that you need to keep data consistent. Otherwise, the data reports inside of analytics won't be filled correctly. So we have this now prepared. And again, we need to go through and build a tag for this. In our case, this can also be copied. So let's copy our event here. This time, it will be a promo click event. Also gonna change the event tracking parameters. This will be a promo click. And we obviously want it to pick up different data, not the view data, but the click data. So this is now specified as well. And we want to change our trigger out. So let's click here and get rid of our visibility trigger. And in our case, it would be simply a click trigger. So let's go here for our clicks. And I'm gonna go with the all elements trigger. And let's keep it generic for now. I'm gonna build a generic click trigger. Let's save this. Before we move on, I need to configure my built-in variables. So we actually have our click element, click ID, and so on enabled. Let's refresh our preview and debug mode. Go back to our page and see how our variables get filled. I'm gonna click on the add. Now this didn't do anything. Let's refresh here again. Oh, that's why we had a semicolon error in our custom JavaScript variable. Let me just figure out what this is all about. It's probably simply because we have some white space here. Let's get rid of this and save this. Refresh. And this time it does it. Okay. Refresh our page. And I'm going to click on this with the command key pressed. We have our GTM click, our EE promo click already fires, that's fine, but we want to restrict it to only fire on our ad. So we're gonna look into our triggers here, our variables, and we see here our click classes get filled, and we have some information here about the click classes. Let's go with the WP image 71. So if that's inside of our variables filled, then we want to fire this. So I'm gonna turn our generic click trigger into a specific one on our ad click. And I'm gonna install a filter, and that filter will be on the click classes if it contains WP image 71. Let's save this and again try this all out. press this button and we see our click has fired. If I click anywhere else, it also generates a DTM click, but nothing fires. So this works fine. And we have now deployed our data. Let's see if it is received by Google Analytics. Let's go back to the real-time reporting under events. We see that there are some new events here. We had our promo click, 3x promo click, and that data should then also have attached our enhanced e-commerce tracking data. We can actually check inside of our, let's go on to inspect here. This will open up our developer tools and we have under the console, let's reload our page actually. Here's our Google Analytics information. The page view has fired. Now also our page promo view should have fired. And now our click with the command key pressed. Yes, we get our data in here as well. The creative and so on, everything that we have filled in. But this time it's a promo click. So that data was transferred over to Google Analytics. We already saw this here in the enhanced e-commerce click was just registered. Now let's look into our conversions under e-commerce reports, marketing and internal promotions and go to the right date. And we see our internal promo clicks were also registered here. So this data was transferred correctly. Now, this is it with this little tutorial. Just to recap, we have put in the right data layers into an enhanced e-commerce tracking variable. And this is a custom JavaScript variable that just returns our e-commerce object with the right data. And then we have triggered a event tag through Google Analytics that transports that data over to Google Analytics correctly. So it doesn't use the data layer. It doesn't read from the data layer. It reads from our custom JavaScript variable. And this is how you can fill these reports without actually deploying a data layer, but doing everything through Google Tag Manager, which is quite beneficial if you have only one promotion running on your page, just like this one. All right, so there you have it. This was it with our little tutorial here on promotion tracking with the enhanced e-commerce tracking features. Now, it's always astounding to me that you can utilize all the built-in mechanisms of Google Tag Manager, such as the element visibility trigger and then also the click trigger to make this deployment happen. I'd love to hear from you if you run into any problems or if you want to use this tracking deployment. If it has helped you, please leave us a comment down below. I always love to hear from you guys. And if you like this video, then give us a thumbs up and also subscribe to this channel if you haven't yet, because we bring you new videos just like this one every week. Now, my name is Julian. Till next time.